Hello friends, my name is Naeem and in this video I'm gonna show you how you can crop the background around the picture by using PowerPoint. I'm using PowerPoint 2019 and in this video I'm gonna show you two type of techniques that you can use and crop the background around the picture. Before we move to our today's tutorial, if you're new to my channel, please consider subscribing it and leave your comments in the comment section. Let's move to our today's video. As you can see, I have already some pictures in my presentation and I'm selecting this image which I want to crop the background. Let's go to format and I'll use the first technique as remove background, this option on the top left. I'll click on it. So as you can see, PowerPoint is trying to guess the area which will be considered as background and the body part. Okay, so it has also taken the body into the background area just because of the background is blur and it is some of the object in the background are matching with the body. So no worries, we have some option here. So here is the first option, mark areas to keep. We can mark the area which we want to keep in the picture and mark area that we want to remove, for example, as a background. So if you are not satisfied with the changes or the job which Microsoft PowerPoint has done, we can use this discard all changes. Once we are satisfied, we can hit this button, keep changes. So let's select this option, mark areas to keep, and you see the change on the cursor, it become kind of a small pencil and you can draw with it. You can see the green color here. Great, so it worked well. And let's do this here. Okay, so keep doing it unless you get your final result. Okay, so this area looks okay. Let's crop the background. Choose this option, mark areas to remove, and draw it from that far, which is fine. So all of the background has gone. Let's try this area. Okay, that's great, it looks fine. Let's hit this button, keep changes. Great, so PowerPoint has done a great job here to remove the background. This is the first example and let's look at it, the second example, which is a little bit more complex. I'll select this image, I'll go to format and I'll hit on remove background. So in this image, as compared to the first one, has taken a lot of area, a lot of even the part of the body into the background. But let's see how we can make this picture as perfect image. This is a little bit complex as this is more blurry and you can see the light is passing through the hair. So let's choose this option, mark areas to keep. First I will do it on the hairs. Okay, great. Let's do it here on the body. Let's do it here. Okay, a little bit here. Okay, this looks okay. Let's remove the background, select this option, mark areas to remove. Great, it has removed it. Okay, do it here. Great, so we are okay, it looks okay. A little bit here before we press okay. Sorry, we need to do the mark areas to keep. Okay, that looks fine. And let's hit keep changes. Okay, as you can see, this has already taken a little bit the area of the face. No worries. Let's go back again to the same option, remove background. Okay, which was not visible to me. Let's use this button again and mark it here. Looks fine. Okay, that's great. So in case if you're not satisfied with it, you can go back again and you can redo it. And if you want to completely discard all of the changes, you can reset the picture like this. And I'll go back with the same which I have already cropped. So let's look at it, our third example. So this example is the most difficult example and complex as well, because the hair color is matching with the background and it will be very difficult to remove the background as the system cannot distinguish between the hair color and the background. If the same area like the shirt color is matching with the background, this will happen again. If we wanted to remove this, it will be very very difficult. So this was just for the illustration. Let's move to our second technique. So here I have an icon. I'm selected it. Let's go to format and go into color and use the set transparent color. Click it. Before you click, you see the difference on the cursor, which is a hint that you have selected this, and click here. So it has removed the background very well, and but it has left some of the outline here. But if you're using as a small icon or something somewhere, it will not be much visible. Let's look at the second example we have here. Let's select it, go to color and set transparent color, click here. So this has done a good job here. And let's look at the third example. Let's select this, go to format and color and set transparent color, click here. So great, so it has also removed the background. Let's look at the second last example here. Okay, let me select this, go to format and select color, set transparent color and click here. So the difference here, so there's a condition: if the background color is matching with any other color on the part of the icon or the picture body, it will also be taken away, it will also be removed. So this is a kind of condition for this set transparent color option. So let's move to our last example. As you can see, this is kind of a gradient color background. It has different shades on different places. So let's try and see what happens when we do with the same option, set transparent color, click here. Okay, it has removed a lot of the areas, but it has kept some of the gradient areas here and some of the shaded area here and underneath it. So this is a limitation with this specific option. If you have a gradient kind of or different colors background, it will not work. It will work on the like kind of a solid backgrounds where you have a solid area. It will work very well. So this is it for today's video, and thank you so much.